It's a penultimate day of action at the Hockey Women's World Cup 2022, and it's semi-final two. Germany take on Argentina. Well, these two battling it out for the right to face the Netherlands in the final tomorrow. Germany back in the semi-finals for the first time since 2010. Their record this stage of the World Cup. Played 9, won 4, lost 5. Their last win in a semi-final was back in 1986, when they beat Canada by all goals to one as West Germany. Argentina have also been in 9 World Cup semi-finals. They've won 5 and lost 4, with their last semi-final win coming 12 years ago in Rosario, where they beat Germany by 2 goals to 1. Germany, of course, came through Pool A, qualified second, so they played an extra game up against Argentina, who won fairly comfortably. Germany faced up in Amstelveen for the first half of this tournament, travelling down midweek to take on the Argentina side that had been based here in Talassa throughout this tournament. Top four in the world contesting these two matches. Argentina ranked second, Germany fourth. The last time the semi-final lineup included these four teams, Netherlands, Australia, as well as these two, was back in 1998 in Utrecht. The only time, other than 2022, that those four have been in the semi-final lineup. But they have won this tournament. Amongst them, Dutch have won it 8 times, Australia, Argentina and Germany / West Germany have all won it twice, and there have only been 14 editions, so you know how to get over the line to the Sonntag. It should be fairly busy today. And let's see the heroics from that quarter-final against England. Let's have a look at the hero leading scorer. David looks like this. Scores Alani van den Boren lead the way with 6 goals. Engelbert has 4. Adrian Garcia have 3. And there are 4 others that have 3. Vandana, Nicky Lorenz, Olivia Menis, Charlotte Stafford. So 3 of them playing here. This is the 25th meeting between the two since 2013. Argentina have a healthy head-to-head record, as you can see, winning 13 of the previous 24. Germany just the 4 wins, 7 ending in a draw. Okay, let's get down and hear from the coaches.
And team, welcome to Terrassa. How the team settled in?
Perfect, actually. We had a good travel to Terrassa, no problems at all with the airport. We have a great hotel, we love the climate, and we are looking forward to the game.
Semi-final of the World Cup. It's been a while since Germany have been here. 2010 the last time you're in the Final Four. Big stage for the team today.
Yeah, but we are looking to today and not the past. And that we wanted to be here, and we also want to be the best of our version today. So for us, the adventure is really to start now.
How do you be the best of your version today?
And we want to get the game going on our side, because we play against the powerhouse. They're very good in defense, they're very good in offense. On paper, they are basically unbeatable this year. So we need to play our best. We have to get the game on our side to create from our chances the scoreboard situations. And we need to be our defensive best, because we have to control the game defensively in order to have more ball possession than we had, for example, in the Pro League. So it's the best challenge we can have today.
Listen, best of luck. I hope you get the performance you want.
Thank you very much.
Fernando, semi-final of the World Cup. You must be very excited and looking forward to the game. Your thoughts?
Yes, I think that it will be a very close match, like the other semi-final, because are both very good teams. So we will see.
Argentina had a very difficult game against England, which you won. Another difficult game tonight. You seem to be grinding out, getting the results in difficult matches. The team seem to be on point.
Yes, we go to look for find the match. And then, for example, England last game defend very well. Also today, Germany, I think that will defend very well. So we hope to break the match with our attack and with our corner.
How do Argentina impose their game tonight? How do they win the game?
with patience and with possession in the ball, know where attack, and keep care with the defense also, and with making goals.
Best of luck, Fernando. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Coaches, Edgar, the umpires, the Antipodean pair, Mitch Newman of Australia on the left, and the Church of New Zealand on the right, Kelly Hudson of New Zealand. So here come Argentina and Germany, their fourth meeting, in the last 12 months. They also met before the final stage of the Olympic Games in Tokyo back in August of last year. Argentina winning that one by 3-0. Argentina also winning the two Pro League meetings this year, 2-1, 3-1 in Berlin. Teams have made their way out. National anthems.
Germany's first, and then Argentina. Please, ladies and gentlemen, stand up for the German national anthem. Y a continuación, el himno nacional de Argentina. And now, the Argentinian national anthem.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Wright, that won silver at the Junior World Cup in South Africa back in April, as was Brinley Heights. That starts to see. As for Argentina, Mela Suchi, after her race against England, continues in goal again. It's Renato, Renato, and Alvatore up front for Fernando Ferrara and his team. There is Benjamin, which has been called upon as well. Argentina averaging 107 caps per man, 27 years of age average age. Germany 25 years of age average age, 82 caps. Advantage for Argentina. Michelle Staffan is going to see by Tabahar scoring. Three times in the first three games. It's Germany who get the second of the two semi-finals at the Hockey Women's World Cup underway, wearing the all-black strip, attacking the goal away to the right-hand side. Argentina in their traditional blue and white striped tops, blue scores and socks, and it's Germany and Kalinski immediately into action at a penalty corner inside 23 seconds for Germany. Had a chance to introduce my co-commentator. I'm delighted to say, joining myself, Charlie Booth, coach across this one, is Hecky Lemming. Hecky, what a start!
Incredible, Luke here. A penalty corner immediately. Well, this is what we expect, right? We expect fire, we expect energy, we expect a good semi-final. And we started off immediately.
Well, in lockout stages, Germany, 1 from 22. They have 1 from 14 against South Africa, none from 8 against New Zealand. Kalinski, who won the penalty corner, then getting on the end of the drag flick and looked at the bench.
What a start of this match.
Well, neither side had a chance to get into the game, and we're only 30 seconds
first,
in, so first bit of action.
It was a corner, it was a goal.
Seems to be gone, more of the same, thanks very much. Well, what a start this is. Argentina. Worst impossible to beat. They went through the Pro League season and beat it pretty much as this squad. Certainly the last couple of months has been as this squad. They look pretty sharp here. They were down against Canada. Quite the same. One, I would be amazed if that ended up anywhere near that game tonight. Sanchez to Maria Granato. Granato picked up by Cincinnati. Looks under the arm. That's the free hit. Cincinnati still going. Cincinnati in the circle. Across the face. Goal! Sanchez just by. Vicky Granato. With the deflection in front of the keeper. And it goes across the face of goal.
Cincinnati running over the side, hitting it to Vicky, and Vicky Granato. Yeah,
she's
touching it.
Goes Alani. Gets the ball back. Granato up against Singapore. Into the foot of Alvatario. Throws the area ball, looking for Staffenhorst. This is Costa. Goes away to her right. She's running back. Big ball to left.
So technical, they're so fast, and they have so much power in their play.
It's actually a decent tackle in the first one, just rebounding back into the circle onto the foot.
Yeah.
Borzolani wears the three. Stopping the ball. Good ball. This castle. Borzolani looking for the deflection from Rio Granato. But Sonny Zimmerman absolutely solidly behind that one. Had a chance for the counter attack. But Kroninski couldn't get out of this little cul-de-sac, which he does really well.
Borzolani. Very well defended there. Start of this match, Jari.
Yeah, incredible start.
Also, we didn't even mention it, but there's a great atmosphere in the stadium. A lot of Argentinian people. They're always a flyer, so.
Well done by Benson. Where's the mask? Difficult for Jette Fleschers, having, I know she's been training with the team and sitting on the sideline, but then suddenly to get the call for the semi-final.
I hope she realizes she has nothing to lose, she can just do only her best.
Chance here for Arose. Arose shoots, good save from Valenzucci.
Circle saved by Suki. Skills.
Thank you.
Hegemeyer between us. Trying to look for something.
Good hit. By Cuccinetti. The circle goes. Atlantic defending by Clear Mertens. They're off down this far side here by Germany. Oh, nice work from Albertario, skipping past a couple of German defenders. Albertario into the circle. Runs out of pitch. Wonderful bit of skill though on this near side. First time ball sort of swept round the corner, go out of play. The high percentage result. Yeah. Reset. Long. Costa, Forzolani. Soze. Horse just picking herself up. She's running to Corzolani, I think.
Again. Dario, left side. Some 3D skills there, but down control the ball.
Every time ball goes over the back line, Jeremy defend, or the keeper makes a save. Valentin Alkenberg's out there, placing the fists in the air, pumping the air. It's on the bottom screen, a bit disappointing, gesticulating. Really impressed in this game so far. Yeah. Schroeder. Cedric sideline ball, taken by Pieper. Final 2.5 minutes. Nozzolani and a chance here now on the reverse deck. Farmer past the far post. A number of chances in this opening quarter here, Germany.
Sigurata with the ball, going for the left-hand shot.
Germany had 41% possession this quarter. And you say that they are looking the more dangerous side. Sideline ball for Granato against him once more. Three here.
Granato in the back line.
Wobble. There it is for Cicinetti. Oh, it's going to miss. What a chance for Vicky Granato. She completely missed it.
Upstairs.
High ball?
No problem.
Kelly?
Yes.
Argentina are looking for a high ball in the circle.
Okay,
off the stick of Zimmerman. You can argue that they've had the advantage. Here, come down here, watch Zimmerman. There. Get, have another angle. Here you go. German stick. German stick. It's not. Kelly Hudson thinks that's dangerous.
That's a mercy.
Brzezinski has to take evasive action. You see from this angle. There.
Do it. Oh,
it's real over. Drama.
It's over. Much of a movie, right? Pirates of the Caribbean. What will you say?
Feels like the Caribbean, a bit.
Well, actually, it does. Super hot.
This isn't the bit.
No, it's the.
I think it's hard.
Yeah. You see, Brzezinski, she has to like do something.
Then is it onto the foot of Morton? Well, I'm not sure. I don't know how you. I don't know how to suggest. So there's a miss and then there's a foot. Yeah. So maybe, maybe that will help.
Yeah.
They did say originally a foot, and then they went for the
first
high
ball. First they said a
foot, then, yeah. That's definitely dangerous. The
That is a foot.
There's a foot, yeah.
Ever, I have a decision for you. There's a dangerous ball and no clear advantage, so you can award a penalty corner and Argentina keep the referral.
Thank you.
I
think honestly it was a dangerous ball because Bronkinski, she had to like dive almost away.
There goes Alani on the left, Costa on the right. And they swap over. And it goes to the right-hand castle, Gorzolani. Number one running is good, it's still there for Gorzolani. And a real reward. So, going up there, but thinking about keeper. Okay.
Gorzolani.
I think that's come up into a body as well, actually. Yeah. That's a good non-referral. Gorzolani again, that time's injections. Benner has gone straight through the keeper. Argentina on level terms. We have a goal inside the opening 30 seconds, and we have a goal 62 seconds remaining on the clock in the first quarter. And it's the goal machine, Gorzolani, who scores her seventh of the competition.
Your second pass of Gorzolani.
It's come off the defender. Gorzolani goes top of the goal-scoring charts, the hero goal-scoring charts, all by herself now. A seventh of the tournament, a sixth of a penalty corner to go with a penalty stroke. She scored against Spain. And the Argentinian supporters in fine voice. Gorzolani, Costa, comes up and over the top into the space. It's a lovely looking ball for Toccolino to run onto. And that is the end of the first quarter. Toccolino still up and running, hasn't heard it. But the first 15 minutes has come to a conclusion. And what a 15 minutes we have. A goal at either end of the open quarters. German 1, Argentina 1.
It's a movie, I'm enjoying it. No, it's crazy. Quarter really time. Cool. First quarter. Yeah.
And your take on it?
I think both teams are on top of it. I think Germany looks really good, but I also think, you know, we know that the skills, the qualities of Argentina are insane and they show it. So
well, this is the opening 25 seconds. Great deflection from Kroninski. Felicici beaten for only the third time. That's a great save. Four penalty corners for Argentina. They scored. Germany had some really clear-cut chances.
Because this was also quite a chance.
Rava had one that she put across the face of goal. Kroninski just getting the touch in front of the keeper. Levert it underneath her. And it don't seem so lonely. Lift it up and chat.
second quarter underway. It's Germany 1, Argentina 1. Germany taking the lead in the first minute of the match. To the equaliser in the, near enough, the last minute of the opening quarter. In between, both teams have been called upon. Percent possession for Argentina that first quarter.
Michelle on the ball.
Out
to the left side.
Rose. This is a Rose. Selena Rose, great tackle coming in. Still there though. Oh, Germany, and they've got themselves a penalty corner. There he is again. That's the reaction. Penalty corner attack. Saving the penalty corner defence. On the other one, it goes to Ruiz. Ruiz with a slam, good save, good clearance. Is that in? No, it's not.
For me, the ball's gone off. You'll stick the two players together, it's danger. And I've blown the whistle before it's in the goal. Bring it back.
Are you happy?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Good, clear.
Absolutely, yeah,
brilliant.
I agree. We'll see it again. Slap shot. And then rebound.
So much she thinks it wasn't dangerous.
Yeah.
Thank you, Hudson's really happy they didn't go upstairs for that one. Not that was dangerous or not. Clear explanation from Alicia Newman that allows Schroeder then to make a decision.
Yeah.
That one spills away to the right hand side. Costa.
Costa.
Costa got by Ruiz. Here is Stappenhorst. Stappenhorst dances past the first attempt to tackle Topolino, but then is dispossessed. Renato. Moving the ball around there, I think, rather than trying to dribble it out. It's quickly taken by Wenzel.
Circle. Great save by Suki. And then Stappenhorst, who tries everything.
Semi-finals are contrast,
wow,
aren't they?
Wow. They are.
Fences. Dominating semi-final one. This one is a much more open affair.
Yeah.
Both sides having a go. Australia pegged back quite a lot in that first semi-final. Renato picks herself up. Go to work again with her lovely skills. Costa, Topolino.
chance for Fleischer. Trying to go around it and hitting it way too high. No on target. But she was standing there totally free, unmarked in the circle. Argentina should be careful with that.
Start to think about that left to right drag, yeah. And the ball is bearing down with them. Can you please just play that pass out to the left hand side? Pozo, out of the Argentina right hand side.
Costa.
Costa goes up and over the top looking for a Pozo. Gently closing the gap. Pozo, so very tough decision for the Church is making.
Spoken to her for her pushing and the 22. Right, both teams, no more. Right.
Church leading the right act.
Loud and clear.
Police from Germany. Carrio, Sosa. Pozo goes down the line, looking for Tome. Nice work from Tome. Has the support behind. Connect with Toccolino. Here is McKeel. Ruiz. Argentina won. Germany. Seemingly getting, I get the feel, executing a good game plan.
Yeah, definitely. As if they made a plan, they stick to the plan, and they don't do it just a little bit, but everything they have. A lot of power, right?
Germany 41% possession in the first quarter, 69% possession in the second.
Yeah.
And a lot of it in the Argentina
half. And I think we said it before during the cool phase of Argentina as well. Their attack is incredible. They have, I think, one of the best attacking lines with the sisters Granato, with Albertario. But this defense, sometimes, well, is a bit weak.
On paper, I would agree with you. But has that forward line fired?
No. You're right. But I'm sure there's a lot of... There is, every opponent knows there's so much danger within those three players. But you're right, it's not. They didn't really show everything yet.
Well, that's a dangerous bouncing ball in from Rosalani. Deflected behind for a long corner. That's Toccolino. So is that. Germany, Biedermann, that was stepping up. Mm-hmm. Pinchinetti. Here's Alonso. She can turn and move this left hand side as she wishes. She has Sanchez here. Sanchez goes down the line, looking for Albertari, picked up by Ricky Renato. She cuts back in field. Renato, great tackle for Vicky Lorenz. Renato gives away the free hit. She'll just wait.
Jeremy just switch off.
They stop playing.
I think she keeps that in. That's his pull back.
Yeah.
So there's the touch of the defender. I think it's the touch of the defender. I think it's Mertens who gets the touch. Albertario's celebrating. Sorry, it doesn't get the touch.
Yeah, but there is no clear reason to change your decision. The goal stands.
So it is a goal. I don't think it's Albertario's. It's whoever had the cross. And in all the excitement, I can't remember. I think it's Lorenz. They've got upstairs.
And it's free hit, and you have players there to defend it. And the goal stands. The goal stands. The goal stands.
Thank you.
is it like a goal scored and it's a bit unclear if the defender, if you touch it or defender, celebrate it as if it's your goal, because, you know, like, you will get this 5-goal.
First time I can see them really faced any sort of pressure, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. This is a hard match for them, the first really difficult one.
And they're so far standing up well.
Yeah, for sure.
Here is Schroeder, Stappenhorst, high skill from Stappenhorst again, corner. High skill to Sinéros, attack. Here's Vittorio Granato. Chance here, Sale Rose. It's the look of Cedres on the reverse. Portman can't get the shot away, but Rose has had a couple of sights as a goal. Costa will see this down, and there is the half-time hooter. And Argentina, who conceded inside the 30 seconds, have turned it around inside the first half. They go into the break in front. Alvatario with the second. Half-time score, Germany 1, Argentina 2. What a game. What a game.
What a game. Nerve-wracking, to be honest.
An impressive performance by Argentina and from Germany to apply the pressure to Argentina. But Argentina responded really well. There's more to this, you feel. Half time, Germany 1, Argentina 2.
Nine shots apiece.
So
circle penetrations also the same. 45% possession for Germany, 55% for Argentina. Fascinating half of hockey, though, isn't it?
It is. It is. And I'm sure the next half is going to be fascinating as well. For both sides.
Germany seem to be doing pretty well. Other than trying to find the net, which has been a problem the last couple of games, they've done everything right. They've created the opportunities, haven't they?
Yeah, and I think also in their defense, they're strong. They mark them. They're in the circle. They mark them well. Good pressure. They have to score goals.
Second semi-final. Remember, the Netherlands await in the final tomorrow evening with Australia in the bronze medal game. Head-to-head against the Netherlands in finals. Let's see if they get a chance to free back. Second half underway. Argentina attacking the goal away to our right-hand side, leading by 2-1, having been behind. They turned it around in the opening 30 minutes. Now can Germany find a response? There is Schroeder. Isa looking for a ruse. It's going to keep it in play. Cincinnati. The foot of Wenzel.
Dario.
From Soze, here is Granato, Maria Granato, good skill from Zimbabwe. Knew that Victoria Granato was on her left shoulder, so then went to her right shoulder.
Victoria Granato
gets it back on the corner. First time ball, Maria Granato. Schroeder. Schroeder picks it up onto the foot, fully taken by McKeel. It's caught on the right hand side. Ganitsky. Schroeder. On the top. In the corner. Pick up Garber. Zolani will take. Cinetti. She goes. Obviously by Wenzel. Cinetti still going. Trying to spread out the left hand side. That's worked for her. It's arriving. Sanchez. Sanchez. She's getting a stiff ball. It looked like Schroeder. Thank you. between us. Chance to scrape his left hand side over. Flushes is coming on for Stafford Horse from the deep jump of Jan Kunas. Lisa.
Rosa
weighing up the options, goes back to Costa.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, plenty of space for Alonso to use. So the best trap didn't hurt her too much. Sanchez's slap is cut out by Grunitzky. Then off the stick of Maria Granato. Granato, lovely skill from Granato, turning Granitzky inside out, gives away the free hit. Solid defending once again from Germany, so he's done their homework on Maria Granato.
High pressure.
That's a ball that Husa wanted, wasn't it? Zimmerman. Difficult.
Pretty under pressure, yeah?
Yeah, well done. Yankees. Taken. Need to find that pass. Fleshens. Deeper up to her left. Chinetti gives away the free hit. Where's that one going for? Up off the stick of Gorzolani. Just on the edge of the circle, Mikiel will take it. Mikiel, good hit. Morgan drops it out. Morgan once more. Cross it comes. Save made by Suchi. Long corner gem.
Sanchez in the corner, the captain of Argentina.
Nicely done, that's a free hit. Thank you.
was going to come out of the East.
That actually makes it look worse than the original.
True,
play.
True. Again.
I just didn't see Fleischitz come from behind. No whistle, so Fleischitz continues to play. Foster, Souza, she's going to be dispossessed. Schirm, very unlucky.
My God!
Got that pretty cleanly. Sedges on the line. Oh, good defending. Again, on the floor, Konitsky's having an excellent game for Germany. Nice skill, still going Cedrez. Jeremy's spending a lot more this quarter in their own half.
He's struggling a bit with the high press of Argentina now, but that also means that there's a lot of space behind the first line of pressure.
Martinez brings it back and hold on. Someone's going to get a card here. And I imagine it's going to the rent. I'm not sure what. I do not know why they are down 10. I did not see what she did off the dribble that she got upended. Friendly corner. Against Germany. Locking them all the way. She's been given the card. Takes a step to the left hand side, it goes to Costa. Costa, good save, and then onto the foot. Work from Sontag.
Here we see it.
Actually, drag straight
yeah.
Onto
the foot. Oh, Dario.
Sit off and all the way down to 10. Granato on the reverse. Zimmerman, here's Maria Granato, shot! Deflected wide, good defending. Sanchez, still going, Sanchez. Sanchez pulls it back. Thank you.
transfer for Germany.
Lorenz. A slide to the head of the circle, trying to find Pierre Mertens. Mertens was behind. Forward in the shirt. Costa. There's Alani. That's just such a useful weapon, isn't it? When you can flip the ball half
just
the
left. Throw it away. You're under high pressure.
Your decision. You may award the goal.
And it's Germany 2, Argentina 2. Martin Alderweireld with his hands above his head. That's the end of the third quarter. And Drama does it again as we get another goal.
Yeah, let's see it again. So here we are at Suchi with the rebound there. It's Stockenhorst with Ski. It's a great goal. So suddenly, we're back again.
So let's have a note. We have fourth of the competition. Twitch from Bensucci. Marvellous finish from Charlotte Stappenhorst.
I agree. I think this is what we all wanted, right? Such a spectacular match.
Here are the highlights.
Here, this was a great action of Vicky Granato. How'd she get the ball there?
This is the one that is no one wrapping around the back. Running out in the third, Stappenhorst finds the net. The fourth and final quarter of semi-final two underway. Germany 2, Argentina 2. It has been
an enthralling semi-final match. It's one of those matches where neither side deserves to lose, but one will have to go out. To the top of the circle, comes a new cutout, and a chance for an early break here, led by McKeel. McKeel, to down the corner.
Beautiful skills.
Find the ball across, looking for Fleshwitz. Germany, haven't they? I mean, Kira Hall was playing the back line, and they've replaced him with Fleshwitz, who's playing at the front line. Yeah. Ball across, that's a dangerous ball. Looks to Sil Pieper as it biting a touch from his teammate.
Did he take that?
Ginetti. He's got Vicky Granato just here in front of that. Granato still going. Maria Granato's in the middle. And Victoria Granato penalised for protecting the ball with their stick. Interesting down below us on the bench. Free hit for Germany. Now this is one that's been taken. Vets has taken that. It wasn't ending on, and then she tried to style it like she hadn't taken it. Granato driving, still going for Granato. Yeah, she's just over.
Triple
lost her balance. And then one back by Victoria Granato. Closer to the Argentina.
To the other side.
And one of the assistant coaches of Argentina is taking exception to something that someone has said at the German bench. We hit for Argentina. This is the match. This is a match that deserves to be won by a bit of skill.
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Zimmerman goes up and over the top. It's a good looking ball as well. Now a chance for McKeel. This is Rava. Rava, short-handed stab into the circle, trying to pick out Stapel balls. Didn't hook out with her teammate. Orban on that far side, which is left the ball now to Ruiz. 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 Foza. Pozo. Costa. Zalani. Zalani goes up and over the Kunas, Ruiz is there, back in the field, Wenzel, Lorenz, Stappenhorst. Stappenhorst, try to open it up,
go across to McKeel. Got that left hand down just in time before Granata found the foot. Has to be an Argentina. Direction was in Germany ball, but Germany threw that into traffic. Pozzo.
Could be taken.
Pozzo. They are in shot. Can't take it. Save. Oh, the snap shot. Tomei. And Sontag makes the save.
Okay, we're looking for a stick tackle on the circle.
There though, I mean,
yeah.
There she did.
And then again,
Kudelski just whacked the back
yeah.
of the stick.
I think twice,
there.
Yeah, here. And here again, right? I don't know.
The first one is.
I agree.
She's got the ball at the end of her stick and she's
yeah,
got
and
the
she's
back.
Yeah,
she's
skipped that. Because there's no way that she can get the ball. It's just
stick. Alicia, there is no clear reason to change your decision. You played on, so it was a free hit out, and Argentina lose the referral.
So, Albertario goes upstairs and loses the referral. and a half minutes remain.
Vicky Granata putting pressure there.
She's at full length. Good work from Germany.
Kauser.
Kalitsky to get it out.
Rosalani. Maria Granata.
Maria Granata driving from the corner and wins the free hit. Alonso goes down. Look at the table. Cedres comes in field. Cedres pulls it across. Gorzolani switches with Costa, goes to Costa, looking for the deflection, and the whistle had already gone, Rui Granata's put it in, Victoria Granata's not happy. Can't unblow the whistle though. Gonna go to Gorzolani, drag flick. Well, Schroeder had the ball and went down that end, and it was ruled out.
Yeah, we see it again. Gorzolani went all the way up.
That's not missed by much.
We've seen her doing it before.
Cuts back in field, goes down the line to Maria Granata. Granata has three German players around her. And a chance for Alvatario. Alvatario into the circle. Alvatario!
Alvatario lifting into the circle with her backhand.
Here we go for the lottery of a shootout. Bashuts utilizing the green card. Soccolino. Alonso. Costa. Gorzolani. Patience here. I should see that. still going. Toccolino. Toccolino's ball across the face of goal. Here's Ricky Granato coming in the corner.
And then the match
starts. Oh, you win. It's been 2-23.
Germany are asking that there's a backstick before the foot. Okay, we'll look for a
backstick in the circle. I thought it was a self-referral.
No, it's from Germany.
There's a the backstick. There, yeah, backstick to Vittorio Granato right there.
Concentration.
Off the stick, and then it hits the back of the stick. And it has to have hit the back of the stick to change direction.
Yeah.
Misses it. Defender gets it. There. That is 100% backstick. Sure. It has to be the back stick because the front of the stick isn't facing the goal and the ball's coming from behind the stick.
Yeah.
I just missed it. It has to be the back stick.
I agree.
Alicia, there is no advice possible. Is difficult to, I cannot see if it is a stick or a foot before the back stick, so stick with your original decision and they keep the referral.
Thanks.
Zolani, over the top. Good number one running.
First goal, goes Zolani.
Okay, Mertens, there's a shot, comes in, rebound, and Germany scrambling clear. Throw the aerial down the other end. Pass. Germany to come again. Remember, Germany's still down to 10 players. They're still on the green card here, Germany. For about another 40 seconds. Alvatario. Alvatario's got space. Alvatario away from Huso into the side netting. Trincinetti got the shot away. It was into the side netting. Verstappen holds. Another punch in the air. Giovinazzi. And Germany back to 11 with 40 seconds.
Given a penalty corner for danger, Germany are saying no danger.
I'll look for you.
Who's dangerous? Up in the air.
I love the way, as a team, Germany are like going, yeah. What?
There's no clear reason to change your decision. Stay with the penalty corner.
No, Germany that is dangerous up off the corner.
Yes, it is. But I had to try.
The last 30. And it comes, it goes to Gozzolani, good number one running. That is excellent work from Pieper. It's still not over. And it's fine. Here's Victoria Granato. Brilliant defence again from Germany. It was Nicky Lorenz with that one. We are going to go to a shootout here in the second semi-final because it's finished. Germany 2, Argentina 2, nothing to split them. And so we have the lottery of a shootout. Steppenhorst getting the equaliser at the end of the third quarter. No goals in the fourth. Final score after four quarters. Germany 2, Argentina 2. Well, Germany that go into this on a high, having given all that defensive effort in the back end of it?
I felt like at the last minute, right, Argentina was there. They were on top of it. They bursted out of energy and everything. So I'm sure Germany's really happy to have the shootouts right now. See some highlights.
Let's not forget they had it in the net, Argentina.
They had it.
Great finish. Of the two keepers in that second half.
Would that mean that she's super sharp now for the shootouts? Who knows?
So we have. Well, she's played three games in this tournament, Kubalski, so she's not coming in completely cold. She's coming into this game completely cold.
Get me a re-sport move. Super difficult for Argentina.
Tome, Alvatario, and Sanchez. Well, here we go. This is fascinating. Like I said, it's a shame it wasn't decided in four quarters by a bit of skill, and we come down to this lottery. But it is what it is, and let's see what drama unfolds in the shootout. Germany, Kowalski takes up her place on the goal line, and it's going to be Jankunas who's going to get us underway against Natalie Kowalski of Germany. Scene is set. The five that we so here we go then. Jankunas up against Kowalski. Jankunas has made a mess of it.
Yes, good girl.
Kelly, we have given a 16. Argentina asking that their stick is blocked and held by the goalkeeper.
Okay, well, look for a stick tackle.
There's been a bit of a mess in this,
yeah,
she?
She's here. She lost the ball. She lost track of the ball.
Then does grab the stick.
Yeah.
It's withheld.
Yeah.
Just here. Yeah. And then she grabs
here,
the stick.
Here. Yeah. I agree with Angela, but she doesn't protect the ball.
Yeah, well, that is the problem.
Yeah. Here she's already.
As the says there, she's holding the stick there.
And all, even with the.
With both the stick and hat club
and
together.
Yeah.
Alicia, there is no clear reason to change your decision. So stick with your original decision on 16. And Argentina lose their referral.
And maybe it's because she didn't have the control of
the ball.
Anyway, it's Nicky Lorenz up against Balancucci.
See it again, Nicky Lorenz. Going back at him. Shot is not on target.
Doesn't miss by much, does it?
Yeah. Well done by Super Dome. Closing the goal.
Alvatario up against Kowalski. Nil all. Alvatario, nicely done. Still going, Alvatario scores. Pace.
Yeah, this is really good.
So, and Schroeder now up against Belén Suchi. Suchi comes all the way to the fixed spot. Now she backs off. Nikki Schroeder make a decision. Finish. Good finish. Belén Schroeder, now the smile breaks out. So Delfina Tome of Argentina, their number 39. So, Argentina back in front. That is some finish. It was telegraphed she was going that way. Kowalski was trying to go that way, but she just did it quick enough.
What a shot. Well played, that's all.
Argentina!
This is our finish. So, Linnea Wiedemann now of Germany. Just 18 years of age. What a tie to step up and be counted. Can she convert into the body? Still there. On to the post as the hooter sounds. On to the post as the hooter sounds. From the 18-year-old Linnea Wiedemann.
Let me see it again. Dern. On Suki. And then on the post. Can you believe it?
I'm not sure it was inside the 8 seconds.
True.
So, Agostina Alonso to make it 3-1 to Argentina and really put the pressure on Germany. Alonso scores! And it's now a must score for Sonia Zimmermann.
Alonso, nice pace here, turning around, making sure goalkeeper is moving, pushing it into the goal. As easy as it looks, but nerve-wracking.
So Sonia Zimmermann must score, otherwise Argentina are in the final. Zimmermann into the circle, up against Suchi. Zimmermann scores. There's life in the old dog here. Forward step the skipper.
Zimmermann steps up and does it.
Sanchez, if she scores, puts Argentina through. If she doesn't, Selena Rose must score, otherwise Argentina get through. They've got three bites of the cherry here, Argentina. This one, though, is in their control, and it's the skipper, Sanchez, who comes forward. Sanchez looks a little indecisive. She is indecisive, is she? Pass Kowalski. Back stick of the keeper. It's a retake. Kowalski did everything right, and then
it's a retake. It's on the back of your stick. Yeah, no, the back of your stick was in time. Yeah.
Here we go.
As if he couldn't make the drama any more intense.
Sanchez again. Yeah.
Sanchez with another opportunity to win it for Argentina. Sanchez looks a little bit more decisive. That's the end, she scores! And Argentina are through to the final. The cruelest of defeats for Germany, who came so close and pushed the heavy favourites, one of the heavy favourites, all the way, took them to a shootout. A real disappointment for Germany, but utter delight. What's your thoughts?
Wow, it was incredible. Those shootouts, and then Sanchez two times. The first she looks so indecisive, and then now the second one should kick in. Wow. No goal. Super important. And what a disappointment for Germany.
Smiles on one side, Vicky Lorenz in tears, a painful moment for her. But it's Argentina who are celebrating and will come back tomorrow. The top two in the world will battle it out for World Cup glory. But listen, I have to say, Linnea Wiedemann, I take my hat off to you. She's 18 years of age. In the World Cup semi-final, she's put her hand up. This is my first take.
Super impressive.
Really, yes, it hurts now, and she will go over and over again. But I tell you what, it takes some courage.
100%. And they say it all the time here, this is where legends are made. Like this girl, 80 years old, she will learn from it, she will continue. She has so many years. This is an experience. It's really cool, super impressive.
So Argentina will be back tomorrow night. Pauline Heinz, who is at the Junior World Cup in April, now finds herself on the main stage. And over on that right hand side, Kowalski is being consoled by Sontag. By Carver. But Germany played such a full part in a really entertaining game. And Suchi, class actually is straight over to her opposite number because she had a great game sometime.
This is beautiful, right?
Yeah. No doubt that they desperately wanted to win it, but look now. Lars of Altenberg wishing Argentina all the best in the final.
Yeah.
Play hard to win. And if you've given the performance.
This, look at this. Suchi with her experience, everything, going to the opponent, the goalie. To cheer her up, I think that's world class. Really.
It promises to be. Germany played an excellent game. I'm really impressed with them.
Yeah.
It was on both sides of the technical table. Oh, they were pushed all the way there, weren't they, Argentina? First time they've come under real pressure in this contest. Okay, let's get down onto the
park. The award is given by Mercedes Cogan, Vice President of the Royal Spanish Federation. We have with us Sofia Tocalino from Argentina, Player of the Match by Iberdrola. Congratulations. Congratulations. Tomorrow you will play the final against Netherlands. How are you feeling?
I'm super happy. I'm proud of this team. I think we deserve this, and we are going to the final with all the energy.
And about the supporters that are here, like every day you are playing.
Thank you very much, and I hope you are here tomorrow. Eh?
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks.
Well, trust me, they've got to calm themselves down because they've got to go again tomorrow. The Netherlands will be absolutely delighted that that was as hard a game as they could have possibly had, and they've got the extra distance. And now.
This is the thing, right? It's already late. Once they've got into the bed, they can sleep and take the rest. You know? I'm sure the Netherlands has some benefit there.
What a game we have had here. Vittorio, she had another good game, always trying to carry the ball forward, always trying to be a thorn in the side of the Germany defence. Yep, no idea why he'd be so happy. and in years to come. I just find it was a great day. I just find it interesting. Because they haven't been there since 2010, it means a lot to them to be there, but they've still got another game
you
to go.
You have fought until the end. You were very close to be on the final. You have fought very, very hard. But tomorrow you can be winning a medal. Is this something that to be happy or proud of, all the World Cup that you have played?
Well, obviously, if you play a semi-final, you want to be in the final, and I guess we get a couple seconds to be, a little bit sad about today's result, and then obviously we'll wake up tomorrow and fight for a medal.
Will you be and all your team 100% tomorrow after this tough?
Say again, sorry, I didn't understand.
Will you be able to be at 100% in the tomorrow match?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
You're not going to get any other response to that question. They've got to pick themselves up. It's going to be hard. We saw 4 years ago Australia really struggled with that loss. Spain. But let's have a look at the highlights of the shootout. Almatario gave them a perfect start. Well, actually, it was a miss, wasn't it, from Cincinnati first up, but then.
Yeah.
Schroeder with the reply, 1-1. Cheeky finish. And then as soon as Tome scored and Biedemann missed, it was a real pressure situation, wasn't it? Fantastic advert for the game.
Really, it was amazing, yeah. This was the semi-final, everything was open for, I think.
So here are the final results. The Netherlands beat Australia in semi-final 1. Argentina win the shootout 3-1 against Germany to make it a Netherlands-Argentina to final tomorrow. Thanks for your company this evening. We'll be back same time, same place tomorrow. Until then, have a great evening and we'll see you then. Bye-bye. Gracias.